Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let's see all about common emitter configuration, guys. So basically, in the previous tutorial, we have gone through common base, right? So I have just drawn the diagram right in front of you so that I explained you really clear for you. So now let us go through common emitter also in the same, common emitter also in the same manner. So basically, we know that this is our transistor diagram. So I need to make the emitter as common. So I'll be drawing the transistor in this manner, guys. Okay, so this will be my diagram. Okay, so this will be my emitter base collector. Fine. Okay, so now we managed to draw the transistor somehow. So in the previous tutorial, as I have told you, that we need a ammeter in series, a ammeter in series, a voltmeter in parallel, a voltmeter in parallel, so that our body is done. So similar to common base, here also we got a configuration that is nothing but positive positive. On both the upper side will be the positive, so I'll be also changing this to negative positive, guys, so that will be really clear for us. Okay, so I'll be drawing the positive like this. So here there will be a variable resistance, and this is going to range. Okay, similarly on this side also it is going to be the same situation. Okay, right. So positive, negative, positive, negative. So start traveling, guys. Positive is going like this, like this, like this, traveling inside, inside. So positive, positive, negative, negative. Similarly positive, positive, negative, negative. Fine. Okay, now let us write the battery names. That is nothing but VBB, and here it is nothing but VCC, and here it is in between base and emitter, here it is in between emitter and collector. So this current is near base, so IB. This current is near C, so IC. So that's it, guys. Our diagram is successfully designing is done. Okay, so from the diagram you can directly say that emitter is common, base is input, collector is output. Okay guys, I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So basically the input characteristic, guys, remember, for most of the cases the input characteristics is almost similar to a normal PN diode, a normal PN junction diode transistor, guys. Okay, so the input characteristic will be like this, but in the previous case, if we increase the current on the output side, we used to get it on the left side, but here we got on the right side. That's the only difference between common base and common emitter, whereas common collector will have a completely different graph. Don't worry about that. Okay, so I hope everyone is now clear with this. So remember one more thing, guys, if you are drawing the output characteristics or input characteristics, just give me a second. Okay, so basically when you are drawing the input characteristics, you will be taking the output voltage as constant, and you will be drawing the graph between these two, voltage and current of the input side. Similarly, when you are drawing the output characteristics, you will be taking the input current constant, and you'll be drawing the graph for these two. That's it. So now I hope you got a small idea. So further moving on, I hope now everyone is now clear with this diagram. That's the reason why we are trying to change VCE. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on that. So further moving on, input characteristics are drawn between the input voltage and input current, keeping the output voltage constant. Yeah, that's what I have just written in the statements, guys. So this is the symbolic representation, and VCE is equals to zero. That is nothing but constant. So by keeping VCE 0 and increasing IB slowly, so if you want you can just change this, guys. So this will be our NPN. So this is connected to P, and this is connected to N. Yeah, this is again forward bias, and this is negative bias. So it's nothing but reverse bias. So it's in active region, guys. So our diagram is absolutely correct. Okay, so as emitter base junction is forward bias, hence the input VCE is similar to forward bias. Yeah. When VCE is increased, the width of the depletion region increases, the reverse bias collector base junction width increases. Okay, so In this situation, it's going to increase, guys. In our common base, it's inversely proportional, and here it's directly proportional. That's the reason why in that we got on the left side, and in this we got on the right side. Okay, so that's the main difference, and hence width of the base decreases if IB decreases. That's the reason why the curve shifts towards the right. So that's a key point. Okay, so further moving on, the output characteristic graph will be something like this. So we'll be having a reverse saturation point, cutoff region, and an active region. So output characteristic is nothing but we'll be making input current constant by drawing along VEC and IF. VEC and IF. Okay, guys, that's it. That's what I have just drawn here. So the graph will be like this, guys. You can just memorize it, or if you want, you can go through the theory also. I've just written it on the next page. Don't worry. Okay. So basically, I think I have just forgot to discuss that thing, guys. So basically, the large signal current gain of common base is alpha, guys, and the value ranges from 0.95 to 0.99. So alpha is nothing but, if you want, in terms of formula, it is nothing but the output by input, guys. Understood? So it is nothing but IC by IE. Okay, guys, so now I hope everyone got a small idea on that. So, okay, the output characteristics are drawn between these things by keeping IB constant for each setting of VCE. Note down the readings and draw the graph. Now plot the graph. That's it, guys. So basically, in the large signal gain or something tutorial, what's that tutorial name? I forgot that. General equation, I think so. General equation of transistors. So, yeah. In that, I told you about beta, right? So beta is equals to alpha by 1 minus alpha. So I'll be substituting these values, guys, into that alpha position. So initially, I substituted 0.98, so that's the maximum value, and 0.985, that is nothing but, okay, that may be 0.9 and also, it's okay. But here, for if you observe, I changed how much, guys? 0.005. For 0.005, how much variation did I get? Almost 66 minus 49, right? So it will be 5, 16, 7, 17. I got 17 variance vary with just this much change, guys. So for a small increase in alpha, there is a huge large change in beta. So that's what I just told you. So if alpha is changed about 0.5%, the result of beta will increase up to 34%, guys. That's an important thing. So hence, these are the common conditions or relations of in CB, guys. Those are nothing but saturation, cutoff, and active. So active, I hope everyone knows that. Okay, let us go through them one after the other. It's really simple and easy, guys. So basically, the region of the curve to left of the line of OA is called a saturation. So in the graph, it is like this, right? I just remember all the graphs, guys, basically. Okay. So this area is our saturation, including this also. Okay. So in this, both junctions are forward bias. So in this, both the junctions are forward bias. Positive, positive. In this, both the junctions are negative bias. Positive, negative. Okay. So this is a small trick for just for statements, guys. So that's the reason an increase in the current base does not cause any corresponding large change in IC. Okay. So further moving on, the ratio of VCE to IC is called as our saturation resistance. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so the region below IB naught, this region. Okay, that region we call as cutoff region, guys. Okay, so in that region, both the junctions are in reverse bias, guys. So guys, if you write these statements, that's enough, guys. Got it? Okay. So in the center region, that is nothing but our active region, where the uniformity is there, and it is called as active region as the emitter base junction is forward and the collector base is reverse. So that's how the active region is formed. Okay, guys, so now I hope everyone got a small idea. So if the transistor, it's not transformer, it's transistor, is to be used to as an amplifier, it is used to be operated in active region. Yeah, we have discussed that. So basically, now let us go through the parameters. Those are nothing but the H parameters, guys. We can call them as H parameters. Okay, fine. So basically, input impedance. We have discussed that previously. So shall I fold the paper so that it will be clear for you? Okay, just give me a second. So you will not have any confusion. That's the reason why I'm trying to fold it. Okay. Okay, both are visible. Excuse me. Okay, both are visible, right? So input impedance. Basically, impedance is equals to resistance. Those both are similar, guys. So R is equals to V is equals to IR. R is equals to V by I. So it is nothing but voltage by current. So input side. So it is nothing but input voltage by input current, keeping output voltage constant. That's it. Further moving on, output admittance. Admittance is reciprocal of resistance. So that is nothing but I by R on the output. So output current by output voltage, keeping output input current constant. That's it. Fine. Further moving on, reverse voltage gain. That's fine. Reverse voltage gain. So reverse voltage means it will be input by output, guys. So input VEB by VCE. That's what I've just written. Keeping IB constant. So whatever the input or the output is in the numerator, that particular term's voltage or current will be writing constant, guys. Got it? Okay. So similarly, forward current gain. So it refers to current. So that is nothing but forward. So output by input, IC by IB. Okay, keeping VCE constant. Okay, guys, so now I hope everyone got a small idea. If you want, you can write down these values, guys, at what ranges they vary. Okay, guys, so in the next tutorial, we'll be going through one more last configuration, guys, that is common collector. Thank you. Thanks for watching.